Jace Rick, I'll tell you what, I am pretty fired up today. I'm in a very unique place today, and we're going to do something that's going to kind of take this day to a whole nother level. I'm in the Ironwood Memorial, and it's really so far pretty incredible. Now, we're going to a butte called the Cocoraque Butte. Now, this butte is supposed to have the most petroglyphs in one area anywhere in the Southwest. And so I'm really stoked about this. Look at what we're looking at today. You know, we got something that never happens. We got cloud cover, which is so unbelievably different usually in this state. And today I can't wait to get out here and experience this, which is really an incredible sight. And we've got one of the most unique situations that I think we've ever experienced. So we're not just after petroglyphs, we're after maybe the first rock show ever that's been performed, right? How crazy is that? But I can't wait. We're gonna get out here and we're gonna find this. Where we're going is right to that rock mass. If you can see it straight through here, that's where we're heading. But there's interesting stuff all the way along. So we're gonna walk down this fence line. And you know, every time I think we have seen everything, come to find out we haven't seen anything. So I am really excited about getting up here today. I can't believe that I've got, you know, 86 degrees, cloud cover, unreal. Look how beautiful this is. Now, let's talk a little bit about Ironwood, right? One of the most unique things about this Ironwood is that it was here when some of these ancients possibly were here. They believe that this wood, these trees, because it's so toxic, is that they can last 600 years. And how incredible is that? They call them basically nurse trees because you'll see them a lot of times right next to cactus. And it's one of the few woods they say doesn't float. It's so heavy, it sinks. Now right there is Cocoraque Butte. And I don't know if I'm saying that right or not. That's what it appears to be for me. In the map, this was the most dominant mountain, or butte, I should say, for petroglyphs. Now, there's supposed to be thousands here. And so we should be able to get up this mountain. Most of them appeared to be on this front side. So we'll take a look over here, but we should be starting to see this kind of stuff pretty quick. I mean, they should be all over, you know, from what I've read and what I've seen in pictures. So it shouldn't be very long before we just get into a whole, you know, whole bunch of stuff. And I'm going to try to take a little walk around the base, I think, before I try to head up. Most of them appeared to be more on the higher side, but we'll see. I can see some trails walking around here that some people have been through here. I've yet to see any so far. I guess what we'll do is we'll start to go ahead and take a hike up there now that we've started to see some. Take a look. Well, we've seen our first petroglyph. Right there we spotted for sure. Some things have kind of looked like petroglyphs, but these are definitely petroglyphs. Look at this beautiful sight here. Man. Okay, there's a second one right there also. Look at there. Look at that. So here we start. Look at this view. My God. How beautiful is that? Oh, there's a whole nother rack of rocks over there on this point. Oh my gosh. Look at that. How cool is that? So now I can see that we have two structures over here. That is an incredible petroglyph right there. That is incredible. I love that. I got a feeling this door has just been opening. Now, let me in, let you in on the secrets of Cocoraque. Is that it possesses something that not everywhere possess, and that is, it's another one right there. This is what appears to be kind of the home of the bell rock. And the bell rock, you might ask, is, well, what the hell is the bell rock? The bell rock are rocks that, when struck by another rock, have this tone that they believe the ancients used for all kinds of different things, from music to rituals to, you know, maybe alarms. But specific rocks have specific tones. And so we brought a wood mallet, basically a stick, that we're going to test that out and see if we can't find some of these bell rocks and see if this myth is not maybe true. Now, a lot of the petroglyphs up here, one of the most incredible things about them is that this was called the flower world. So a lot of petroglyphs that you're going to see in this location has been channeled after flowers. So what we're going to do is we're going to look for also these bell rocks, right? Now, a bell rock is going to have a surface similar to that right there. See how those have been beat down? And we're going to listen to see. See how that's kind of dull? That's got more of a... So we're seeing all kinds of petroglyphs up here. Now, there's supposed to be more petroglyphs up here, and the diversity, and you're really seeing them on this side of this hill. Over 70 bell rocks that you can tell were struck by rocks. Now, we're not going to strike it with rocks. We're going to use this wood, which is going to give us the same tone. So please, if you come out here, do not bring a wood mallet or grab a stick. You're not going to hurt it with a stick. But, wow, I tell you what, this is, I mean, look down here. You're seeing work all over. Now, a lot of these were flowers. There's a bird right there. It looks like a bird. But a lot of these are flowers. This area has an abundance of flowers. And they believe this was the flower world up here, where there was almost what you might call a religion to a certain degree of the flower world. And there's a 1921. Look at this out here. I mean, look how incredible that is. Look at that guy. They always come to see me. They always come to see me. Now, this looks like one right here. So let's see what it's got. Hear that ring? That definitely sounds like a bell right there. Listen to that tone. If you look right here, so let's get down in here, right here. Okay. Now this point right here, see it? Look at that work over here, up here. You know, make sure you stay away from the petroglyphs. But this is an incredible place. I can tell you already, this is a special place. Look up there on that ridge. Let's take a look over there. Let's get up over here and see what's up with this. little dugout area right here. Areas like that really look cool. So now we're up here, we're taking a look at this old tree. This tree just, I mean, it's perfect up here, man. That's perfect. Now, one thing about when you used to hunt in those days, now one thing about an animal is an animal breathes on every stride. So where if I'm running, I can run 3 or 4 paces without breathing. I can actually control my breathing, where an animal does not. And so a lot of times, even though these beasts were faster, the ancients could outlast them and tire them out. And so that's how a lot of times the kills were made. Now look at this right there. That's a perfect. Now that looks like a bell rock right there. But that just might be from a predator bird out there. Look at that little bird right there. Come up here to see us. Must be a rock wren, because he's in the, definitely in the rocks. So look at this stuff we found. Now most of these designs that look archaic are from the flower world, which means that these have been designed after the flowers. Now I don't know what that is, but this is a really special place. I'm telling you, you can feel it. There's a feeling up here that is unbelievably powerful. Now that looks like a rock right there that's been struck. There's another, oh shit, rock. There's a flower right there, looks like. So right there, see this? Definitely looks like an area that has been, I don't feel the bell on that one though. So they believe that the flower world was somewhat spiritual, somewhat religious, combination of nature, combination of animals and flowers. You know, one of the things I wanted to try to do when I got up here was get the vibe. You know, what kind of vibe's up here? Was this a spiritual location? You know, is this places where they pilgrimed to, you know, had pilgrimages from other locations? You know, was it that special? Now, one of the things about this place that makes it so special also is that because it really hasn't been really explored, you can come out here and find stuff that archaeologists haven't found. I mean, they haven't really done much work here. Now, it's said that they used to make tones from this and these different rocks. Now, I'm going to tell you a little story about my house. I have different wind chimes and they're different weights, so I can tell how heavy the wind is, how much is blowing, by what bell goes off. And I'm sure they had trained themselves to the same way, that certain rocks meant certain things with certain pitches, because each rock has its own an individual tone. And I tell you what, I'm not a musician, but I'm telling you, this whole thing, now that's got a ring. There was the first rock concert right there. How incredible is this? This definitely has a lore. Oh, look at this rock over here. Look at this. Here is the one. Now that just, that's an incredible like bird. Now a lot of their stuff was birds as well as different flowers. So look at this rock right here. Look how incredible that is. Oh, listen to that. There it is. That's a bell rock right there. Hear that? That is a bell rock, folks, for sure. Anamorphic, zoomorphic. Look at that. That is an incredible piece right there. Look at that guy. Wow. And he's right next to this rock here. Listen to that bell. Wow. Look at those guys. That guy there looked pretty damn mean. And there's supposed to be other glyphs, like in these sections, right through here, right here, and across. They actually said there were shards here, so I don't know where they would be. But if we look at these here, look at that beautiful piece right there. We're going to work our way over there to see that. That's an incredible piece right there. I like that a lot. Birds are all over this area because birds are part of it. Birds, the animal side, the plant side, the music side, the rock side. The flower world was definitely prevalent on this area. That is a beautiful piece right there. That is definitely worth walking over, climbing over, trying to get to that right there. There's a nice one up there on that hill as well. That is a beauty right there. That is definitely a beauty. What an incredible journey we're on today. And then you pop right over there and see that. Look at this view right here. Give me a good grip. Look at that thing. We're really getting in down into a spectacular area right in here. Let me get down. I tell you what, these are a whole nother level right here. I'm going to get around here and turn around so you guys can see these. But I'm telling you what, that is a different level right there. Look at that. You know, that almost looks like some type of scripture to a certain degree, as funny as that might sound to you guys. Just the way that's laid out. I've seen a lot of petroglyphs in my time. I can say that I'm pretty fortunate to be, I'm not K, but I've seen a lot, and I've not seen anything like this. I have not seen anything with the distinctive lines like that. That is absolutely incredible right there. That is unreal. Zoomorphic, anamorphic. Archaic. I mean, you've got definitely different generations of what I believe will be Hohokam. You know, this is really a very special place, and I'm going to call this place out just like I would Alter Bridge, right? This is definitely a unique place that had a very spiritual value to it. You can feel the there's a calmness here that, man, is another world. And, I mean, the fact that these ancients worked these rocks and played their music here, and, you know, it looks like they worship the earth, the sky. Wow, look at that. That is absolutely stunning. This piece right here. Oh, look at that thing. Man. Wow. Look at that. What an incredible place, man. I tell you, this is pretty awe-inspiring. It really is. Need to move on down. That's a crazy cool looking petroglyph right there. what I'm gonna do is, there's the main mountain right there, secondary mountain to the right. Now there's supposed to be some stuff through here along these ridges, along this ridge line, till we get to the mountain over here.
There, this rock mountain with the tree on top.
Now what we're doing is we're working our way over to the other area. You know, that looks like that's could be something right up here. I know there's something in this area. Don't know exactly what. This definitely looks like something that could be up here on this point. Sun's come out, got a lot warmer. Is that a petroglyph right there? Yeah, there's, okay, so here we are, right here. And this is absolutely, positively, a bell rock right here. So let's see what kind of pitch it's got. I got petroglyphs over here. So they're all over this area. Here we go. Man, that really, depending on where you hit it, listen to this. Hear that echo? I'm gonna make sure I get around here so you can hear that. That's almost deafening. I don't know how far that carries. You know, as I'm walking through here, I'm backtracking only because I'm seeing petroglyphs on these points, these rock points. Now there's the main butte right there. Look at these right here. Isn't this cool? The little areas where they got a man right there. Yeah, all these rocks, there's a sign right there. So let's guess and see if there's something up here. They could have played up here as well. I mean, if you imagine the pitches and the different sounds and the stuff they could have made. Now these are hard because it tells like, oh, this is definitely one. So let's work our way back over there, see what we got. Yeah, it's a little warm today, but not, man, it's really pretty nice. You know, the bugs have been really bad, the flies, and that's kind of unusual for Arizona. So it's been really neat that it's not been a lot out. There's my first piece of pottery right there. Wow. So there is pottery out here. Look at that, there's a shard. So, it's telling me I'm in an area that they used to work something. I've got a small butte right there. Let's work our way over there and see. The old shit rocks will be minimal. There's a piece right there. So we know we're in another area. That was taken to another level. To go small, right there. The guy down there. He's worth a trip. He's worth a trip. Look at there. I came down to see this guy. Now look at there. That might be the best panel we got. Right there. Look at that. Well, look at that. Incredible. Absolutely incredible. Oh, listen to that. There it is. You know, a lot of them you don't know for sure. And then you hit the perfect one. And you're like, okay. There's the bell rock right there. Now the amazing thing about this rock is that you can see the different strike points and the patina and the rock. And I've been pounding on this one for a long time. You know, they would have had villages down here somewhere. And we did find some a shard, I won't say shards. Here's a rock they've been beating on for sure. This one, pretty evident. This, folks, is an incredible place. This is an incredible place. Unreal. Tell you what an incredible day it's been today. You know, welcome to Flower World. You know, this is really an incredible place. You know, to me, you know, my take on this place is it was some spiritual location that, you know, maybe they even pilgrimaged to. Very special place. I mean, I've seen some bell rocks before, but not to this degree where, you know, it actually looked like they had some type of ceremony, some type of system set up. And what an incredible adventure it's been. Hey, you know, if you like this channel, please like, please subscribe. Hit that notification bell so every time we post. If you can, you'd like to donate. This channel is fueled on Patreon, not by YouTube. YouTube doesn't really work too well as far as that part of it goes, but I appreciate the people that donate to what we do. It's very much appreciated, and thank you very much. Man, I think I've seen what I needed to see today in this location. If you get a chance, man, come down here and see this. This is a spectacular place. I love this thought process of these areas that they keep fairly close to how they were. You know, they don't do any road work. They don't tell you where they're at. They don't tell you they're not here. They don't tell you where they're at. If you do your homework, you can find all this stuff. Man, who wouldn't want to be out here today? That's a long, lonesome road right there.